to this. Okay guys, let's convert this ugly elevation to a better one. First of all, you need to create a crop region here. We have some works over there later. Okay, this is my ground, but you can see the piles, and it is inappropriate for me. You can crop them, or you can go to the masking side, and from here in the model site setting, you can make the elevation of porch base a little bit more, maybe 6,000, and press apply, and you can see it will expand it, and it will be okay for us. Okay, after that, the first things I use is Sill House. It is really good for black and white elevations. You need to go to the model here, go to the graphic and display option here, and from here you have the Sill House. Put it on something like that, white lines to outline the edge of the buildings. It will outline the edges of the building, and it will your building will pop off from the other sides of this elevation. Okay, click on OK. If you can see this, you need to turn off your thin line, and then you can see we have a white line in here, and in the edge of the building and the ground. It is better now. And let me put it my scale on 1 to 50, and then let me hide some of these, maybe this and this. I don't need them, and it is better now. Okay, this is great. And then after you activate the Sill House, you can work with some other things. For example, you can put the, let me apply this to hide to turn off the temporary and hide isolate and convert it to a height element, and then you can put the detail level, and fine, it will show some more details, for example in here and in some other places, that it can help you for this purpose. After that, a great element in elevation that will give you a great detail is shadows. We have two kind of shadows here. Let me put it here. Here we have two kind of shadows. We have cast shadows and ambient shadows. Cast shadows always good, but for the ambient shadows, we need to activate them and see the results. Ambient shadows work perfectly in shaded mode, but in black and white, you need to check it. You need to test it out and see the results. But before that, let me turn on the cast shadows, and you can see we have some geometry shape here, and we can see a better shape here. Let me turn on the ambient shadows here and see the results. You can see it is great, but I have a problem here. And that is, the shadows are really dark. So from here, go to the lighting, or let's go to the lighting, and let me bring down the shadow number to a lower number, or maybe to this, or you can also turn it off. It depends on you, but I personally love this kind of shadows. Also, you can increase the ambient light. It doesn't really affect that much, but the shadow parameter will affect the most in this situation. Okay, it was great. And we also manipulate the lighting setting to see the results there. Another things we have is this part of a building is further in comparison with this part. If you would want to see the results, we have this face and we have this face. In this elevation, we can understand this. We have a way to separate these two faces from each other, and that is depth skewing. And what is that? You need to go to the graphic display option, and in here, you have an option here. You can turn it on, and you have number 0 to number 100, and also you have the fade area. Let me apply this. You can see, but it is really fade. You can make it a little bit darker. And you can see it is a little bit lighter in comparison with the this part. But sometimes if it doesn't work for you, make sure to go to the one of your levels and select the elevation you're working with, and then from here turn on the clip with outline, and after that put this line. Let me select it again. We have this line here with this grip. Put it at the end of the building. This range will be, the 100 will be here and the 0 will be here. Let's go to the new again, and then let's go to the depth skewing again. You can see we have a range here. The 101 is the place that we've specified right now. And you can adjust the near one and other kind of settings, but it most of the time this part will work for me. It is better now. You can see the difference between near faces and further faces, and it is great for us, and we can use it. Okay, the another thing here is our glasses doesn't have a transparency, and we can see in the buildings, or we also can can make them a little bit maybe light, very light blue and with some transparency. To do that, we have two kind of windows here. We have two kind of glass here. We have windows and we have curtain panels. For windows, you just need to go to the, just need to select the family and change the glass material here. Let me select a glass material here because they don't have a exact one, and from here check the user render appearance and put the transparency on maybe 15 or something like that. It is for shading and it doesn't work for here. So let me put the surface pattern on solid, and let me put it on 242, 242, and 255 here. It is great, and click on OK. I will use these glasses for here. To do that, you need to turn on the select pin elements, and in here, select the glass parts here. And then click, then right click, and from here select all instances in the project, and in here in the material tab, do it again. Let me search glass here. We have this one here with the exact parameters, but then when they are selected, right click, and in the override graphic in view, click on by element, and in here apply a transparency to it. Maybe 30% would be great for me. And now you can see, we can see through them. Also, you need to do it for these windows too. Right click and in here, right click and by element, and in here apply transparency here too. Maybe 30 would be great for me. Click on OK, and we are good to go for this, and it is great for us. Okay, we also can apply some PNG items. For example, you can bring some birds, you can bring some PNG people, and you can place them very easily here, but I'm not going to do that right now. But that was a tip that I was sure that I'm I had to say to you to do that in your project. The last thing I'm going to do here is to create a sky here. To do that, you need to go to the graphic display option, and in the background, let me use a gradient here. It is great for me. Let me make it. It is great. It is much better in comparison with the first one. And let me make it a little bit smaller from all of the sides. Maybe a little up. And the next tip here, always make sure your grids and your levels are out of the crop region. It is helping you to make them a little bit better. And then at the end, let me put it, bring it a little bit upper. And at the end, you need to turn off the visibility, turn off the visibility of crop region, and you will have this great elevation here. And also, if you want to use this elevation in another elevation, you need you just need to create a view template here. Let me create a view template, ELV for example, and you can use it in all of other elevation you will create. For example, let me create another elevation here. Here, let me put it on this side. And let me delete this side. Okay, I'm going to delete it, and let's go to the this side, and let me adjust the part, and also let me put the far clip much further, for example 30,000 millimeter, and it is great. And you just need to apply the view template here, and you're good to go. And you just need to adjust some little things, and for bigger parts you don't need to do anything at all. For example, you need to create some transparency, but